This video is going to help you solve bugs when you're vibe coding with tools like Cursor or Windsurf 10 times more quickly. You're going to learn how to put your entire code base into Google's 2.5 Pro model and then get a result that you can put into Windsurf or Cursor, and it's going to help you debug and solve issues so much more quickly than using Windsurf or Cursor directly. So this here is a little app that I've been vibe coding for fun. Basically, it's a landing page generator where you can generate your own landing pages using plain English and just ask it to code it up. You can view the code, preview it. This is a little portfolio page that I made for myself. And there's a bug that I'm running into. So the bug is I want to be able to have users edit the text directly. But right now, when I go to edit mode, the app isn't working. So if I click cancel, it's not working the way that it should, obviously. So I'm going to show you how to use this tip to hopefully debug this issue. So this is something here in Windsurf. I'm sure if you have built anything in Windsurf or Cursor, you've spent hours kind of going back and forth with the AI trying to debug something. Now, the issue is these tools try to search your code base to get the most relevant folders to add to your context when it is asking these chats. And even like their cursor has 3.7 max, which allows you to put in more context, but it's still not bringing in everything. So what this method is going to do is allow you to pull in every single thing into the query. So we're going to go to repo2text.com. That's just repo2text.com, as you can see here on the screen. And then you can either put your GitHub URL or just directly pull in from a local directory and select the file. So I'm going to select my file here for the folder that holds everything, all of my code. And it's going to ask if I want to upload it. So I'm going to say yes. And then we're going to scroll down and you could uncheck certain files, but my app is plenty small enough that I'll have plenty of room. So I'm going to click generate the file, copy to clipboard. And then we're going to go to AI.dev. AI.dev is Google's AI studio. We want to go to the right side, make sure we're on 2.5 Pro experimental. And what I'm going to do is first, I'm just going to type some spaces and then just paste in that code base there. So this is, as you can see, 117,000 tokens is my entire code base. And I have 1 million tokens to work with here in this model. So I have more than enough room, and that's a pretty big app that you would be able to have 1 million tokens here in as the context. So now what I'm going to write is a little prompt to explain the issue that I'm having. Okay, and then here's what I did. I said I'm having an issue with the below code base, which is everything we pasted in. Describe the feature. Users should be able to click edit text. The iframe is supposed to be editable, etc., which doesn't happen right now. We need to make sure that all parts of the feature I described work. And then I like to say at the end, explain exactly what to do to a junior dev who needs to write code to solve this problem and fully build the feature. So we'll just go ahead and we're going to run this. And it doesn't take too long actually to go through the entire code base for our app. And I'll pause the video. And here we can see just right off the bat, it says, okay, we're going to break it down. Here's the plan. Modify these folders, modify the endpoint, and verify the database logic. So everything that I just shared. And then it's writing the code that needs to be updated for each step. And it's still writing here. So we can see we're at 66 seconds. You can see it just going live. And then step four, it's writing the code of exactly what we need to do. And remember, it has all of the code of our entire code base already. So it should be accurate. This is a really powerful model. And under testing steps, I'm going to remove that just because that's more for us and not for the actual code. But I guess actually, I can't edit this directly, which is fine. What I'm going to do on the top right here, under more options, we're going to click copy markdown. Now we're going to go to Windsurf. We're in our code. I'm going to use 3.7 Sonnet. We'll just use 3.7 Sonnet for this. We'll make sure we'll do write. And then I'll paste it in. Now we're on the bottom. I'll just delete the testing steps because I don't think that is necessary. And then we're just going to click enter. So we're going to give that entire prompt to our AI. And now it's going to say, okay, I'm going to help you implement it. So I'm going to pause the video as Windsurf kind of builds this out. And then once it's done, we will test our feature. Okay, so now we're going to test it out. Windsurf finished. So we can see that this is completely done. So we'll go back. Now, if we click edit, I'll just say Seb Kramer is the founder of No Code MBA. And it's pretty cool. Now you can just click directly on it. I'm going to click save. There we go. Changes saved as a new version. So let's just refresh the page to make sure that it actually saved as a new version. And then here we go. I can see now I'm on version 12. So it literally one-shotted that. You all have no idea how long I spent trying to build this before I figured out this trick. Actually, I did this live. I didn't know if this was going to work, and it actually did. I tested this on a different feature and it worked as well. So this one-shotted a really complicated bug that I just was not able to solve with Windsurf or Cursor on its own. So use this when you are building in Cursor or Windsurf. One more thing, this is completely free. Google AI Studios, this model is 100% free right now. It is rate limited a little bit, and it might end up being paid in the future, but right now it's completely free. So definitely check this out. I hope that you found this helpful. Be sure to subscribe to our channel to get more tips and tricks like this when you're building with AI and no code. Check out the link in the description to go to No Code MBA and learn more about building fully fledged apps using no code and AI tools from start to finish. We've got dozens of in-depth courses teaching you how to do this, taught by industry experts. Thanks again for watching, and we'll see you in the next video.